the song with perfect. Because our emphasis is loving the Son of God, loving the Lord Jesus Christ. And in John 19, the 28th verse through the 30th, I'm going to read it. It says, after this, Jesus, knowing that all things had already been accomplished, in order that the scripture might be fulfilled, said, I am thirsty. A jar full of sour wine was standing there. So they put a sponge full of the sour wine upon a branch of hyssop and brought it up to his mouth. The 30th verse says, when Jesus therefore had received the sour wine, he said, it is finished. And he bowed his head and gave up his spirit. We're singing about, as well as we're going to be praying about, the love of our Lord Jesus Christ. And it says here in the scripture that it is finished. Amen. And so when I think about that, I have a lot to thank him for. I have a lot to love him for. We all have a lot to love Jesus for because it is finished. That means that all of my sins in past, present, future, all of the sins of the entire world were taken care of on the cross when Jesus Christ gave his entire life for all of us, those to come. It is finished. That means there's nothing that I can do or nothing that you can do to win your salvation. Jesus already did it. That means that nothing you or I can do to make him love us more. Guess what? He loves us so much that he gave all of who he was for us on the cross. And so now, even today, you hear it. It is finished. And so what I want to do is take a moment, and I want to thank the Lord for his love. I love Jesus today. I love him more today than I did yesterday. How about you? Amen. Amen. So we're going to take a moment as I pray. But then what I'm going to ask each and every one of us to do around our tables, thank him and praise him for his love. Love on him back. Allow him to love you, but love him back. And thank him for this very word that it is finished. This is why I love the Lord Jesus Christ tonight. So, Father, right now, we commit our lives, oh God, to you anew. Lord Jesus, we thank you so much for dying on the cross for each and every one of us, for the whole world, oh God. Thank you. Thank you for giving your life willingly. Thank you, oh Lord Jesus, for giving all of who you are, for the sufferings, oh God, that you experienced on the cross. You took our sufferings. You took all of our pain. You took everything good and bad and ugly, everything that pertains to our life, and you laid it upon yourself. You allowed it to be upon yourself. You were that sacrifice for us and for those, oh God, that we've been praying for, that we're believing, oh God, that you're going to bring into the kingdom, oh God. And we look forward, oh God, to this nation coming back to you because of the shed blood of Jesus Christ. So, Father, we bless you. Lord Jesus, we thank you. And we wait upon you these next few moments as we pray prayers of love to you. And waiting upon you. Just take some time now at your tables, turn around, and you can start to pray, and others can agree with you. Agree with the fact that you love him. Ways of just telling him you love him, thanking him for his shed blood on the cross. He is our Savior, and it is finished. I'll just stand and we'll just wait for a few moments while there'll be prayer at your tables.